In this video, we'll help you get started with your new Kohera 3D Viewer software. So when you first launch the program, you'll see here Project Explorer. We'll click on the Scans folder and then click this icon here to open scans. Navigate to the location where you have your scans. And here I have a combination of E57 and PTI scan files. So I'm going to select a combination of both. And then we'll be presented with this window here, and I'm going to choose every 2x2. I don't need to see all the points for this example. And then if I want to add several scans, having less points will allow me to navigate faster and give less load on the graphics card. But if I need to see extremely high detail, then in that case, I would want to choose all points. So we'll go with 2x2 and click OK. If we expand this folder, we can see the scans have been added to our project. So now I'm going to click on the scans folder and just drag and drop it into the scene window. And down here in the lower left, we'll see the progress of the scans being loaded and added to our scene. So now that the scans have loaded and been added to the scene window, we can begin to navigate around the point cloud data and decide what it is we're trying to do with the data here. So one of the first things you might want to do is choose which units you'd like to work in, how you wish to navigate. Now, if we go over to this dropdown, choose options. Here we have some different navigation modes. To find out how those work, you can go over to the help section here and do some reading through here. Navigating the scene, navigation modes, and this will explain how the different modes work. So are we looking to measure? Are we looking to just view certain areas, create some piping? What are we trying to do? So under tools, we have here the measurement panel. So to measure an item in the point cloud, click one point, click set point, and then click another point and set two. And this will give you the XYZ and the distance, which is this yellow line. And then again, you can switch through your different units. You can also click on the measurement box here and change the dimensions manually if you wish to. So I'm going to hide the measurement box. Next, let's look at creating a volume. So under tools, volume tools. And I will click a point here, go over to the box, set point one. And then we'll click another point, set point two. And then apply. Now, if we click on the volume box, we can adjust its size as well, just by simply dragging the handles and then clicking apply. To hide the volume box while keeping it active, just uncheck the bounds visible. Now, as you're navigating, if you click on a point and then press C on the keyboard, or under home, click center, that will center on that point, and that will become your pivot point as you navigate around inside the point cloud data. To see an area in greater detail, click a point once again and choose set spotlight or shortcut Z on the keyboard, and you can see this circle here giving us a spotlight on that particular area, allowing us to see more detail in the scan data. Now, each scan here that has been added to the scene window has a different color. If we go over to tools, Scene Explorer, we can see the different colors, and we can hide scans as well. And you can also change their colors. For example, this one here, scan 201, we'll click on the color swatch, change that to red. Under Home, we can also go to Point Cloud Coloring and choose Color As Scanned or Uniform Scan Color. Now, Color As Scanned, if these are colorized laser scans, you'll want to choose that option to see the color. So let me show an example of that. I'll switch back to the Project Explorer, and I have a few colorized scans. Let me add those here. Got five of them, and I'll choose, let's go all points on this one. Now I'm going to double click one of those scans. It opens a second scene window. And let me take the other four here and drag and drop them into that same scene. So now that those have finished loading, these are colorized laser scans. So we'll come over to Point Cloud Coloring, choose Color As Scanned, and now we can see the color here. Next, we'll look at adding CAD models to the project. So I'll click Open, and this time I'm going to go down to K3M OBJ. And I have a model here, so I'll click Open. Choose the up axes, Y or Z, and the source units. So I'll click Accept. Once the model has been added, I'll right click on the model, click View. And then let's look at adding some scans for this particular model. So go back to the Scans folder, and then click the Open Scans icon. And let's choose these here. Now I'm going to shift select and then drag and drop those scans into the scene. All right, and here we go. So just like before, we can go to Tools, Scene Explorer, and here we can turn off the point cloud data or the model. Okay, there's also a transparency option. So for the point clouds, we can adjust the transparency. And for the models, we can toggle transparent models and set the transparency level for those as well. Now, all the paid for modules are included with Kohera3D Viewer. They run in demo mode. So anytime a new module is released, those will be added into the viewer. And that gives you a chance to take a look at those. So next I'm going to demonstrate the piping module. So let's remove these other scans that I don't need. I'm going to just close those there. All right. So what I'm going to do is go back to Home, and I'm going to switch this to Color by Scan so I can see the individual scans. And when I'm working with piping, I like to take the size of the scan points and actually reduce those down to one. So I'll enter one and then Tab. And sometimes it helps to adjust the transparency, but I'm not going to do that right now. So let's take a look at fitting some pipe. So earlier we made a volume So I'm going to go back to the volume here, this box, and I'm going to turn the boundary back on, and I'm going to make some adjustments to this. So we'll click on that. And let's go to a top-down view. And I'm going to drag those there. Click apply. Switch back out of orthographic and take a look at what we have here. So let's begin fitting some pipe.